Greetings, Sentinels fans. I bring back the return of the Distinguished Cards lists. Today, we are going to look at some of the first Cauldron decks and see which cards define them. We are going alphabetically in the first set for Cauldron, so we are starting with a fun one, Baccarat, which is especially fun for me since now I have more images of physical cards and I can stop using this one from Wager Master's deck. Baccarat's distinguished cards are Ace in the Hole, Ace of Sinners, Ace of Saints, and, well, whichever trick strikes your fancy. So I will go with Underworld Hold'em. Baccarat's innates tend to be the linchpin of his deck, rather than any of his cards, since you'll end up grabbing all sorts of cards from his deck, hand, and trash with them. For this reason, Ace in the Hole, allowing you an extra card play and allows you to use your innate a second time, can mean a lot to you. Ace of Saints and Ace of Sinners work similarly, where one shields all your heroes for 1 point of damage, and the other boosts their attack power by one. Sinners is echoed by other effects, but Saints is one that I haven't seen before, a party-wide shield. However, there's an upkeep cost for both of these. Every turn, you have to take two copies of the same card out of his trash and shuffle them back into his deck, requiring you to cycle through his deck a lot, which thankfully he has cards for. And Baccarat is a tricksy person, so he has a bunch of trick cards in his deck. By themselves, they are low powered, but with the way his innates are structured, he can play a bunch of them at once, and thus they ramp up. Underworld Hold'em is my favorite of these, since Baccarat needs his card draw, but this spot can really go to any of his tricks. Next up, we have Doc Havoc. This one was really the only real healer character before Greater Than Games created Dr. Medico's Voidguard deck, and he's kind of funky. His distinguished cards are Cauterize and Rapid Regen. Doc Havoc is capable of dealing damage in his own right, but with Cauterize, he can turn that damage into healing. It's Retico, but in reverse, and since the healing is optional, Doc can choose to be an offensive player if he chooses, or hit his allies in order to heal them. Rapid Regen increases all healing that heroes receive by one, which can honestly get pretty insane, especially if you have sources of healing outside of the Doc. Even so, this can get your friends into great condition pretty quickly. Just a little bit of healing and Rapid Regen can really fix you guys up. Moving on to the Knight, we have possibly the simplest deck in the entire set. He, or she, just does damage and fights on the front lines, sometimes attacking, sometimes protecting. Their distinguished cards are the sword, the shield, and the armor, to which I'm choosing the helmet for this purpose. Oh my gosh, you mean a knight is recognized by his arms and armor? You don't say. Honestly, the one thing he is missing is a horse. The sword and shield are not limited cards, but instead have effects that prevent more than two of them from being in play. This means that while you can have a sword and shield each, you can instead have two swords or two shields in your loadout instead. The sword increases the knight's damage by one, as well as giving him a power that allows him to deal two damage, so a quick way to get some damage out. The shield reduces damage dealt to him and his armor by one, so he is harder to kill. Oh, the armor, yes. Knight's unique thing is that he has armor that are separate targets from him, and he can redirect damage dealt to him to the armor. I am pretty sure that doesn't actually work thematically unless you are under the impression that armor is disposable, easy to break, and can be replaced with ease. But yeah, for some extra protection, Scapegoat Armor. From an old being to an ancient being, the Lady of the Wood is a weird one for this list because nothing in her deck comes up as essential, since she's very much a case of using what you get. You can choose of all the many damage types to get additional effects based on the setup you have, getting the best of what you have of your season cards and equipment. Since I would end up with 8 cards if I included all of them, I'm just going to show these here, and you can behold the majesty of nature. My favorite being the fire-based ones though. I like dealing damage, what can I say? Last in our video today is Malakai. This guy is all about summoning djinn and powering them up. For all that, his cards are Bathiel, my favorite of his djinn, and when I say djinn, I'm not talking about the alcohol here, and the summoning stone. The djinn each have 5 hit points, are autonomous, and if destroyed, they are returned to Malakai's hand, so they come back pretty easily. Bathiel does a bit of energy damage, and if paired with high Bathiel, gets a decent damage output, or a one-time hit of 5 damage if you use the power. Though of course, your favorites might be different. Samael for defense, Ezael for healing, or Reshiel for crowd control. The Summoning Stone gives you the power to play additional djinn on your power phase. More stuff for your fighting. Want to summon and empower a djinn in the same turn? Want 2 djinn right now? The Summon Stone is the card for you. This card is the difference between him being a slow minion maker and a fast minion maker. Alright, first Cauldron list down. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to take a little bit of time off because I want to try out a new project. I'm going to be enthusing about some movies. So, I hope to see you there. Take care, friends. Let's see if this is affected by the green screen. Rapid regen increases all here. I am rushing. I'm going to be enthusing about a couple of movies. That was the best take I've had yet, and you ruined it. I'm going to... Fudge.